And I'm extraordinarily grateful to all of you. And all the stories that I heard and all the conversations that we had are seared in my brain and in my heart. And that's what I'm going to be taking to me when I go to Washington. I'm going to take a piece of you each and every day when I wake up in the morning and I go to the chambers of the United States Senate.
You fuck, baby!
But here's what I've also got to say. Is that, you know, the easy part is over.
That's right.
And now comes the hard part. And the hard part is doing the work. And I got to admit, I like that list of bills that Tony gave me. And I'm going to be working on those bills, but there's a few other bills that we got to work on. We got to do something to make sure that every child, not just some children, get a decent education. Sure that every young person who's qualified, not just some, can go to college and get a good college education. We've got to make sure that every single person in America has basic health care so they're not bankrupt when they get sick. We've got to make sure that in a democracy such as ours, every single vote is counted. And we don't have any monkey business going on. We've got to make sure that all those young men who've gone down the wrong path and those young women who may have gone down the wrong path, that we give them a second chance and we embrace them and pull them back to the bosom of our community and follow in the line of the work that Danny Davis is doing to deal with the ex-offenders in our community. We've got so much work to do. And so I've got to remind everybody here that I'm just one man. And that I can't do it alone. And that no elected official can do it alone. And so I cannot promise to solve every problem. But what I can promise is that I will work hard. I can promise that I will keep you in mind when I vote. I can promise that I'm going to collaborate with these folks right here and folks in every community across the state of Illinois to bring about a more progressive America. But everybody here's got to do their part as well. Young people, it doesn't matter how much money we put into the schools, if you don't have an attitude that says you're going to learn, you will not learn.
Say that.
Parents, it doesn't matter what we do in government, if parents aren't parenting, it's not going to make any difference. We've got each and every one of us responsibilities that we've got to carry forward in terms of training our young people and providing a role model, because I'm not a role model. Danny Davis, Jessie Jackson, Michelle Obama, the main role model these young people are looking at is you. And so all of us, we've got to be in partnership. So don't send me to Washington thinking I'm solving all your problems. I'm going to Washington to work with you in partnership so together we can solve some problems. That's what we're going to do.
There you go.
And before everybody gets carried away with all this talk about what I'm going to be doing in the future, just remember, I've got to do my job right here, right now, first. So don't start asking me what I'm going to be doing next. I've got to worry right now about what I'm doing right here, right now. And I'm proud of the fact that we're going to have offices open the day I'm sworn in next week on January 4th. And we're going to be doing constituent work, and we're going to be doing casework, and I'm going to be having town hall meetings, and we're going to be getting past all the hype to the real business and the real work of improving our communities, and that's something we can only do together. And let me just close by mentioning this, because this is something that's been bearing on my mind. Many of us have witnessed what's been happening on the other side of the world over the last several days. It looks like we've got at least 125,000 that have been counted dead as a consequence of this tsunami. it looks like at least 1 million people have been displaced from their homes. We can't comprehend God's plan in all this. It defies understanding. And the pain and the torment that we witness in the faces of parents who've seen their children swept away, husbands who can't find their wives, we don't understand the depths of their grief. But what we do understand is this, that all of us are extraordinarily blessed. We're blessed to live in the greatest country on earth. We're blessed to have a roof over our heads and clothes on our back. And so, sometimes I think we forget how lucky we are. And we forget how much of a contribution we have to make to other people. So I'm hoping that as people leave here tonight, everybody's inspired. If you haven't already made a contribution to the victims of this enormous tragedy, you should make a contribution tonight or tomorrow. And then what you should start thinking about is the fact that although this is a tragedy that happened in the blink of an eye, we've got other tragedies all across the globe. An AIDS crisis in Africa that's killed legions more than died in the tsunami, but is killing people silently every day. The kind of tragedies that are happening because of hunger and because of ignorance and because of wars that sometimes we don't have to fight. And so I hope that all of you not only keep me in your prayers, but you're also keeping these folks who are suffering these tragedies in your prayers, and recognize the power that you have, and recognize that if all of us together maintain a sense of hope and a confidence and faith in what Dr. King said, that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. It bends towards justice. If we maintain that hope, then I'm absolutely confident that we can educate more of our young people, that we can put folks back to work, that we can reclaim young men from our jails, that we can make certain that people have decent health care, that we can make sure that women are treated just like men are, that we can make certain that everybody has some measure of justice, some measure of prosperity, and some measure of peace in their lives. Chicago, I love you guys. God bless all of you. Thank you very much. GCI, V103, Gospel Station 1390, all the wonderful jocks. I appreciate you guys. I love you. Thank you very much. Y'all give it up.
Take it back.
Get my picture, I'm gonna be worth some money.